So once again, I welcome you all in the paper of virology. Our discussion is going on the topic of structural properties of viruses. And in that already, we have discussed two important structural components, that is the capsid and another one that is the nucleic acid, which is acting as a genetic material. And the third important component of the viruses, which is acting as a part of its structure, is the viral envelope. And today's lecture is concerned with that viral envelope. So question is, again, what is viral envelope? Some animal viruses, some plant viruses, and very few bacterial viruses, they are surrounded or bounded by an additional membranous layer, and that is actually called as the envelope. That means within the structure of viruses, at the center, there is presence of the genetic material or genome. And that genome is surrounded by a proteinaceous coat, what we call it as the capsid. But in some viruses, that proteinaceous coat or capsid in turn is surrounded by the additional membrane. And that additional membrane is called as the viral envelope. It is mainly present in the animal viruses, but some plant viruses as well as a very few bacterial viruses, they show the presence of such envelope. Now, in case of animal viruses, usually this envelope is arising from its host cell membrane, or it can be derived from the nuclear membrane. It depends upon the site where the multiplication of virus is taking place. If the virus multiplies within the cytoplasm, then generally the envelope is derived from the cell membrane or plasma membrane. And if the virus is multiplying within the nucleus of the cell, then generally that envelope is derived from the nuclear membrane. As far as the thickness of this envelope is concerned, it is about 100 to 150 angstrom units. And this envelope is resembling like that of a typical biological membrane. That means its structure is very, very similar with the cell membrane or the plasma membrane of the eukaryotic organism. That means it actually consists of a bilayer of the phospholipids in which the proteins are being amended. So actually the envelope is, we can say, the bilayer of the phospholipids within which the proteins are being amended. We can see here the structure of the HIV virus, and HIV virus is one of the example of enveloped viruses. And you can see here the outermost thick membrane, and that is the envelope. So such kind of envelope is present in the HIV virus. Now, in some viruses, the proteins, they may be projecting out from the envelope surfaces, and such proteins, they are called as the spikes or papillomers. That means from the envelope of certain viruses, some proteins are coming out as a projections, and those projections or those surface proteins, they can be called as the spikes or the papillomers. And chemically, these papillomers or spikes are made up of the glycoproteins. Now, these spikes or papillomers are generally involved in the attachment of virus to its host cell surface. That means the enveloped viruses, they attach to their host cell surfaces with the help of their surface proteins that are spikes or papillomers. In some viruses, a protein is also present internal to the lipid bilayer, and it is called as the M protein or membrane protein or matrix protein. And its function is to stabilize the lipid bilayer. That means in some viruses, inside or below the envelope, there is presence of a layer of a protein that is called as M protein or matrix protein. And that layer of M protein is responsible for giving stability to the bilayer of the phospholipids, which is present in the envelope. So this is the image of the coronavirus. And coronavirus also is an example of an enveloped virus. And in this also, there is presence of the papillomers or spikes that are coming out, or they are that are projecting out from that envelope, with the help of which that virus is attaching to its host cell surface. So now we can see the structure of the envelope of the viruses. In any of the viruses, you know, at the center there is presence of a genome, which can be either DNA or RNA. This genome in turn is surrounded by a proteinaceous coat, and that is called as the capsid. And this capsid in turn is surrounded by a membrane that is called as the envelope. And this envelope, it is made from the bilayer of the phospholipids. And within that bilayer of the phospholipids, there is presence of the amended proteins, or they can be called as the membrane proteins. Now you can see here, this is the bilayer of the phospholipids within which the amended proteins are being shown here. And this is actually the envelope of the enveloped viruses. In some viruses, within this envelope, there is presence of such spike proteins. That means these spike proteins, they are projecting out, they are coming out at the surface. And these surface proteins, they are called as the papillomas or spike proteins. And with the help of these spike proteins, the viruses, they are attaching to their host cell surfaces. In addition to this, in some viruses, there is presence of an additional layer of the proteins below this envelope. And that layer of the proteins, it is called as the matrix proteins. And this layer of matrix protein is responsible for giving stability to the envelope of the viruses. So this is the layer of the matrix proteins. The spikes that are present in the envelope, they may have the property of hemagglutination, or they may have the neuraminidase activity. In the viruses like paramyxoviruses, the hemagglutination and neuraminidase activities are present in the same glycoproteins or in the same papillomas. But in orthomyxoviruses, these two activities are present in the separate papillomas or separate glycoproteins. The neuraminidase activity helps the virus in penetrating the mucus layer of the respiratory epithelium. That means viruses, with the help of neuraminidase activity, they are penetrating within the mucus layer of the respiratory epithelium. And by that way, the viruses, they are reaching up to the host cell. So the neuraminidase activity is responsible for reducing the viscosity of the mucus, and thereby the mucus becomes thin, and therefore the viruses, they reach up to their target host cells. The hemagglutination property is helpful for the binding of viruses to the RBCs, and therefore they are responsible for causing the hemagglutination. That means with the help of neuraminidase activity, the viruses, they are reaching up to their target cells, and by the hemagglutination property, the viruses are responsible for causing the agglutination of RBCs in the host body. An envelope of viruses is always flexible, and therefore enveloped viruses, they have somewhat variable shape, and therefore they are said to be pleomorphic. However, the envelope of certain viruses, for example rabies virus, which is bullet shaped, that envelope is firmly attached to the nuclear capsid, and such envelope gives virus a constant shape. Now you can see here, this is the picture of the rabies virus, which is bullet shaped virus, and this is the cross-sectional view of that virus. In this case, envelope is there, but that envelope is firmly attached to the nucleocapsid, and therefore the virus is having a constant shape. The influenza virus is well-studied example of the enveloped viruses. You can see here the image of the influenza virus also. Here also there is presence of the envelope, within which there is presence of the papillomas or the surface spikes, which are projecting out, which are coming out of the envelope. The next part which is to be discussed here is about the envelope components or envelope constituents. The envelope is made from three important components, and those are: one is proteins, another that is carbohydrates, and third one is lipids. Among that, we will first discuss about the proteins. Now, viral envelope contains two kinds of proteins. That is, one is the host cell-derived proteins, and another the proteins specified by the viral genes. In viruses like arboviruses, rhabdoviruses, and myxoviruses, all envelope proteins are coded by viral genome. That means within the envelope of these viruses, there is no presence of the host cell membrane derived proteins, but all proteins are they been coded by the viral genome. But in leukoviruses, herpes viruses, and pox viruses, it is not clear whether host cell proteins are present in the envelope or not. But these viruses, they contain the proteins that are exclusively specified by the viruses. That means in leukoviruses, herpes viruses, and pox viruses, in the envelope, always there is presence of the virus-coded proteins. The membranes of all classes of envelope proteins, they contain glycoproteins. Within the viral envelope, there is presence of a significant amount of the carbohydrates. Now, which carbohydrates are present generally in the viral envelope? The most common carbohydrates are galactose, mannose, glucose, fucose, glucosamine, and galactosamine. And they are generally found in the viruses like influenza viruses and para-influenza viruses. Carbohydrates in the envelope are not only found as glycoproteins, but also as glycolipids. That means the carbohydrates within the viral envelope, they are always associated with the proteins or lipids, and therefore they can be called as the glycoproteins or glycolipids. The third important component of the viral envelope is the lipids. The lipids in the viral envelope are derived mainly from the host cell. And therefore, the viral envelope is said to be a typical biological membrane because its main component is the lipids and they are derived from the host cell. The different classes of lipids that are present in the envelope are phospholipids, cholesterol, fatty acids, and glycolipids. The different types of the phospholipids that are found in the viral envelope are sphingomyelin, phosphatidylcholine, phosphatidylethanolamine, phosphatidylserine, and phosphatidyl inositol. So these different types of the lipids, they are present in the viral envelope. So that is about the envelope of viruses, which is one of the structural component of viruses. So thank you for your kind listening. Thank you very much.